Let's go before the altar of the Lord in prayer, shall we?
Amen.
Most holy and righteous Father, we give thee thanks, praise, honor, and glory, O Father, for your divine mercy, for your grace, and for your love towards us, O Father God. We praise, we honor, and adore you. We lift your name on high, O Father God, for thou art worthy to be praised. Worthy is your Son, O Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who was slain for our sins, O Father God. Most Holy One, look down upon us this day, be merciful unto us. Keep us ever in your care, O Father. Father God, in your grace and in your mercy and in your love towards us, O Lord, look down upon those that are sick and in need of your healing powers, your healing touch, O Father God. Send forth your Holy Spirit and your healing hands to touch them, O Father God, and bring them back to full health. We know, O Lord, that thou art the greatest healer and the greatest physician. Keep those, O Father God, that are traveling and those that are unable to make it here today into your sanctuary, in your care. Put a hedge of protection around them, O Father God, and guide them and hold them close to thy bosom. And help us, O Father God, to take this message that thou hast given unto Sister Kim this day, O Father God, unto them, O Lord. Help us, O Father God, to be your hands and your feet, your eyes, O Father God, and your mouth. Continue to watch over us, O Father God, throughout this coming week. And we give thee thanks for our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who taught us how to pray as we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen. Amen. Okay. We have quite a bit to talk about today, yes? Alright, so, this immediately following our service, we are having our third class for study for Revelation. So just right after the choir practice, then we will meet in the classroom in the back, Sunday school room in the back, if your schedule permits. We'll be having, on the back of your bulletin, there is some dates that we have printed out Our Monday, Thursday service will be on the 13th at 6 p.m. here. So if you schedule a permit, please be here. It's always a wonderful service, and it's going to be a wonderful, wonderful anointing service. We're looking forward to that. Next Sunday is Palm Sunday. Okay, bear that in mind. Palm Sunday next Sunday. Our board meeting will be on the 3rd of this month, but we're going to go to the 4th Sunday?
The 4th Sunday
instead, because...
The 5th Sunday must be the 30th.
Yeah, 5th Sunday, because Easter is on the 3rd Sunday, so we'll push it back to 5th Sunday. But we'll keep reminding you.
And the discipleship class will be on the 23rd instead of the 17th.
Right, yes. You see how we work together as one body for Christ? I love that. And our flea market.
Yes, I know we already had a certain thing for our flea market for June 3rd, but we decided we want to put it back to May the 20th. So if you have anything that you want to get rid of, please help us out. Thank you.
Yes. And there are some of our family that is missing from here. If you have their number, reach out to them and see how they're doing. Just say hi. I know we haven't heard from Sister Gussie for a while. We were talking about that earlier. Mm-hmm. We haven't heard from Jesse and Karen for a while. Mm-hmm. And Cham also. And as we mentioned, Cham, mm-hmm. please reach out to him or leave him a voice message. His birthday is on the 7th. So I know he's going to receive a card from Friendship, but try and reach out to our brothers and sisters and, you know, give them a kind word, okay?
Mr. P is not here today.
And, oh, Sister P is not here, but...
She's had a family gathering today.
Okay, good. Yeah. I hope she have a great time. I do hope so, yes.
Also, I heard from Joni, she sent out an email, and she had a look at passed away. Keep her in bill and our prayers, and want the whole church to know that, to keep her in the prayers, and then that she was with us and the children.
Okay, wonderful. And
her sister's name is Janetta Hyman.
Janetta Hyman, okay, great. We'll keep her in prayer and lift her up again during party time. Okay. And, I'm sorry.
Joanne Andrews, mm-hmm. Sister passed away, so she's still in.
We just
yes.
said that.
Yes, oh, that's what we're talking about. Thank you for lifting that up and keep reminding us to keep them in our prayer. And tomorrow, the 3rd, which is Monday, Sister Tabitha, there she is hiding. Birthday is tomorrow. So
don't forget our food too.
Yes, our food. Yes, our food. Our when you bring in the stuff for donation for Faith Samaritan, please check the dates and see if there's an expiration date on them before we bring them. And we have some easy to lift boxes in the back. We can just take them off the bags and put them in there, so they'll be easy to carry. Okay. Great. And Sister Tammy will be celebrating her birthday on the 3rd, which is tomorrow. So let's all sing happy birthday to Sister Tammy.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
I'm gonna say it now. There's something wonderful in store for you today. I know that. I'm just saying.
Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna go for lunch.
I'm just saying. Okay. Yes. Is there any more announcement? No? Okay. Our call to worship is printed on your bulletin. If you ever please stand.
A voice cries out in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God.
Remain standing for our opening hymn. Our opening hymn is in the red hymnal on page 618. We'll be singing all three verses. Let us break bread together.
The communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of Good morning.
Good morning.
It's a beautiful morning.
Yes, it is.
Bright morning.
Amen.
We've been looking forward to some sunshine, and we've had a beautiful weekend.
You got it.
This morning, do we have any prayer requests? We've heard a few prayer requests already. Do we have any additional prayer requests?
Yes, my cousin Robert Peter is suffering with stage 3 bone cancer.
The Freeman family.
Freeman family.
Yeah, we lost another member this week.
And Stephen, so I'm going to be here Wednesday to have a more breath problem.
I was thinking this is a good time to lift anybody in career search, but particularly as our teachers are interviewing for the following year and our principals are trying to make the best decisions about
what about celebrations?
It
feels summer in the room today.
Amen. Yes. I feel good.
Like a low energy in the room. Isn't God good enough for us to have a lot of energy?
Amen.
He can feel like it's not.
We're all tired from working in the yard.
Yes.
Now that is very true.
Yes. Fair way to the dandelions. Yes.
But you know what? If we can't do anything else, I always like to say we can always tell God, thank you.
Amen.
Thank you for a lot. We can go down the list with what we are thankful for. So on any given day, even when we're not feeling well with the pollen and things going on and the bumblebees chasing us around the yard, and we can still even thank God for the bumblebees.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
I'm thankful for Evelyn and Miss Lucy and Miss Beverly being here.
Yes.
Friends of the church.
Amen. Amen.
I'm thankful for his mother, Mary, and for Frank and Evelyn. And Evelyn just celebrated a birthday. Y'all don't know all the good things that Evelyn does. I don't have time to listen to her.
Amen.
Way too late.
Amen.
Yeah,
bless you. Let us go to God in prayer.
Amen.
Father God, we come to you with joy in our hearts this morning, thanking you, God, for another blessed day. God, you heard all of the prayer requests this morning. We ask prayers for the Freeman family, our brother who's suffering with cancer. We continue to pray for Brother Rainey, Christopher Rainey, and those who are searching for jobs, God. And we pray for our brother Delroy this morning, God, who's not feeling well, God, but he's still right here on the battlefield.
Amen.
God, we ask for blessings for those prayers that we did not hear, God, but we know that people were praying in silence. We continue to ask for prayer for our nation, these United States, and that you continue to bless us as we walk this road as Christians.
Amen.
And that we strive to be the best Christians that we can be on a daily basis.
Amen.
Father God, I ask for blessings for Friendship United Methodist Church, that we continue to grow, God, continue to love one another each and every day.
Amen.
Bless those who are sick and shut in, Lord, may not be in the hospital, but just at home, not feeling well. Or those who wanted to be here today, but God, they had to work.
Amen.
We ask that you watch over them, God,
and
understanding that you know our hearts and everything that we do. God, I ask that you continue to watch over us as we approach Resurrection Sunday, that we think about your son, Jesus Christ, who died on the cross for our sins. I ask these and all blessings in your son, Jesus Christ's name. Let us all together say,
Amen.
Now we will have a praise song by our wonderful choir, I Am Thine, O Lord, found on page 419. And they will be singing 1, 2, and 4. This morning comes from Ezekiel chapter 37, a very familiar scripture. We've all heard at some point or another about the valley of dry bones. But we're going to go there this morning because it is needed. And we're going to talk about the valley of dry bones in regards to hope. And I will be reading verses 9 through 14, and this time I am coming from the New Living Translation Bible. Then he said to me, "Speak a prophetic message to the winds, son of man. Speak a prophetic message and say, this is what the sovereign Lord says. Come, O breathe from the four winds. Breathe into these dead bodies so that they may live again."
Amen.
So I spoke the message as he commanded me, and breathed, and breath came into their bodies. They all came to life and stood up on their feet, a great army.
Amen.
Then he said to me, son of man, these bones represent the people of Israel. They are saying we have become old, dry bones. Mm. All hope is gone. Mm. Our nation is finished. Therefore, prophesy to them and say, this is what the sovereign Lord says. Oh, my people, I will open your graves of exile and cause you to rise again.
Amen.
Then I will bring you back to the land of Israel.
Amen.
When this happens, oh, my people, you will know that I am the Lord. I will put my spirit in you, and you will live again and return home to your own land. Then you will know that I, the Lord, have spoken, and I have done what I said. Amen. Yes, the Lord has spoken.
Amen.
Amen. I've read for you Ezekiel 37, verses 9 through 14. In the Message Bible, the introduction of Ezekiel tells us that catastrophe strikes and the world falls apart. People respond in various ways, but two of the most common responses is denial and despair. Denial refuses to acknowledge that there is a catastrophe. Mm-hmm. It shuts its eyes tight or looks the other way. It manages to act as if everything is going to be just fine. It takes refuge in distractions and lies and fantasies. On the other hand, despair is paralyzed by the catastrophe, and accepts it as the end of the world. It is unwilling to do anything, concluding that life for all intent purposes is over. Ezekiel found himself living among people who believed that life was over.
Amen.
They refuse to see how bad things could really get. Now this morning, what I want you to do is use your imagination. Imagine yourselves walking out of the church this morning. And as you walk out of the church this morning, imagine when you step off of the steps, there are nothing but bones. Just dry bones all over the parking lot. Everywhere you walk, just dry bones. All on the side of the church, front, the streets are just full of dry bones. Can you imagine such horror when you will walk out, if you will walk out of the church and see such a thing? God gave Ezekiel a vision concerning the nation of Israel. They have become a hopeless people, which is clearly stated in verse 11. Our bones are dry, our hope is lost, and we ourselves are cut off. Their passion for God and for the things of God was gone. Their hope was just lost. Through their compromise of the word of God, they had cut themselves off from the favor of God. Our bones are dry. We've lost hope. Like many people in the world today, they felt they were at the end of the road. There was nothing else that could be done for them. That God had simply forgotten about them. But guess what? There are people in the world like that today.
Mm-hmm.
There are people who are lost. They have no spirit, and they believe that they cannot live again. That God has forgotten about them for one reason or another. There are people walking among us who are like the walking dead. They move about from day to day feeling worthless. They have separated themselves from their family and friends. They won't answer the telephone or a text message. They have separated themselves from the word of God.
Amen.
They've given up. They may feel that church is not even worth attending. They're just waiting for the end, possibly living a life deep in sin because they do not see the need to serve God. But there is a need for us to think about those who have given up. There is a need for the dry bones, possibly in our homes, our churches, in our entire community to live again, to be revived. There is a need for us to speak life, the breath of life, into some who are lost, some lost soul along the way. There is a need for us to stop ignoring those who are often sad and withdrawn and sit around us quietly, distant and lacking the energy to go another day. It is not always because these individuals are sick. It is not always because they are angry. These individuals may possibly have lost hope. They may very well be in the valley of dry bones. In many cases, they've been cut off, whether they've lost their jobs or something traumatic happened in their lives, and they just do not believe that things can change. They've turned away from God's favor. But say this, my sisters and brothers, but God.
Amen.
But God.
Amen.
But God can revive them in whatever situation they're in.
Amen.
In verse 14, it reads, I will put my spirit in you, and you will live again and return home to your own land.
Amen.
Then you will know that I am the Lord. That means something, my sisters and brothers. And I have spoken, and I have done just what I said. Yes, the Lord has spoken. In other words, regardless of the situation a person is in, they can be revived.
Amen.
Because God has already said what he will do. Our entire nation is in need of revival. Our entire nation is in need of the Spirit of God.
Amen.
We need to be filled with the Holy Ghost so that we can rise up against those who have no faith. Rise up against immortality. Rise up against evil and hatred of any kind. Homelessness. We must rise up.
Amen.
Rise up against believing that God has given up on a certain group of people. God has not given up on anyone.
Amen.
He will never leave us, nor will he ever forsake us. Rather than give up or refuse to face reality, as the Israelites did, we have to accept the fact that even in the midst of a catastrophe, God is still at work.
Amen.
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 Nevertheless, sometimes when things seem really bad,
really bad,
we lose sight of God. We drop our heads, not to bow down and pray, but with a sense of lost. I've lost in this life. We look for an opportunity to start over. I wish God would just let me start over.
Amen.
Not realizing that God is still already at work. He never quits on us.
That's right. Amen.
We often quit on ourselves.
Amen.
We become hopeless and refuse to accept that things could really get better if we have just a little hope in God.
Amen.
We say that we believe that God can rescue us out of any given situation. Don't we say that?
Amen.
But do we always believe what we say? At times, we too become the dry bones in the valley. We too refuse to rise up from our suffering. Our spirit becomes weak, and all we can focus on is what could happen if things do not change.
Amen.
You hear that often? What if things don't get better? What are we going to do? What if the bills don't get paid?
Amen.
What is going to happen? What if is one of our biggest enemies in life? Because we can't see past the negativity.
Amen.
We must believe in any situation that things not only can change, but things will change.
Amen.
And then what about the Word of God we talk about all the time? We talk about the Bible. We talk about reading Scripture. But do we believe in our hearts what the word is saying? That's our power, you know. That's our weapon. Our biggest weapon is the word of God.
Amen.
We must remember there is power in the word of God.
Amen.
Ezekiel 37:4-6 reads, "Then he said to me, speak a prophetic message to these bones and say, dry bones, listen to the word of the Lord. This is what the sovereign Lord says. Look, I am going to put breath into you and make you live again. I will put my flesh and muscles on you, cover you with skin. I will put breath into you and you will come to life.
Amen.
Then you will know that I am Lord."
Amen.
Hebrews 4:12 reads, "For the word of God is living and powerful and sharper than a two-edged sword, piercing even to the division of the soul and spirit and of joints and marrow. And it is a discerning of thoughts and intents of the heart." In other words, the word of God goes deep down in our souls.
Amen.
And if the word of God penetrates our souls, then we must believe, even when we are in a valley, that God is still in control. Regardless of our situation, God is still in control.
Amen.
God's word is supposed to give us life. It gives us life. God's word gives us hope. Amen. But see, the Israelites, they didn't want to talk about the word. You know, we get in situations with people when things are bad, people are angry. They don't want you to talk to them about God. They don't want to hear about the word when things are bad. But only when things are good. But when we're going through the valley, remember I said, just imagine those bones if you walk out the door and you're walking through the valley of dry bones.
Amen.
What would you do in that situation? What should we do in that situation? We should walk through the valley with pride and with hope, praying and asking God to raise these dry bones up, God. Give them hope. Trusting and believing that you'll make a way out of no way.
Amen.
God created everything that was created with a word.
Amen.
Remember, in the beginning, God spoke it and it was so. God said, "Let there be light." What do we have? We have light. God said, "Let the waters under the heavens be gathered together into one place, and let the dry land appear." And it was so. Things happen when God speaks. Amen?
Amen.
The only hope for reviving dry bones and for renewing lost hope is the word of God.
Amen.
That is the reason why we cannot stray away from reading the word of God.
Amen.
We talked in Sunday school this morning about leftovers. How we give God our leftovers. What we have left. In other words, we don't necessarily get up in the morning and start our day by praising and worshiping God. And then at the end of the day, we are exhausted. And what we do? Thank you, God. And that's all we give.
Yes. Amen.
That's all we have because we're so tired. We don't have anything else to give.
Amen.
But God said, "I don't want that. I want your fresh fruit. I want it when you're at a high level of energy. At the beginning of the day when your eyes open." We make the mistake in believing that we open our own
Amen.
Eyes. When we got up this morning, it wasn't because we opened our own eyes. God opened our eyes. He pulled us up out of the bed. It didn't have to happen, but it did. But God already said he was going to do it, and he did it. The only hope for reviving dry bones and for renewing lost hope in people is to feed them the word. Breathe life in people with the word. Now that doesn't mean, as I stated before, we're going to walk around and say, "Hey, you're going through the valley. I suggest you read the Bible." Now, you're going through the valley. You need to read the Bible. No, God didn't say judge either. Because at some point in time, who's in here not going to suffer? We're all going to suffer because Christ suffered. Amen. We're no better than Christ. Amen? Amen. So when people are suffering, then we can talk to them about how the word has blessed us. Let me tell you what God did for me when I was going through. And if he did it for me, I know he'll do it for you. Amen? Amen. If you want to live again, if you really, really want to live again, to be revived and not continue, if you're in a valley of dry bones or you know someone who's going through the valley of dry bones, let's offer them the word of God. Let's have a renewed spirit and have a belief that the future can be bright. Then we must hear from God. See, in many situations, because of what's going on in the media, what we hear every day, let's just be real. What we hear every day, what we hear that's happening on the social network, what is it? Not Facebook. Every time we hear something posted on Twitter, we do what? We assume the worst. It's over. Things are not going to get better. But we must keep our hope and trust and believe that God is in control.
Amen.
We don't have any power. All of our power comes from him. Amen. Let's not find ourselves in a valley of dry bones because we're listening to what's being posted on Twitter. Let's not find ourselves in a valley of dry bones because we're not praying about what's being posted. And see, there's a reason to pray. We don't even have to look for a reason to pray. All we have to do is wake up and walk outside. We don't even have to walk outside our homes. There's always a reason for prayer. A hopeless people must not remain silent. We must not remain silent. We may not be hopeless, but at times Christians become silent when others are going through the valley. That's all the reason for us to stay in the Word, share the Word, and don't ever forget to pray.
Amen.
We must pray and believe that there is hope for the future. And guess what? Prayer keeps us in close communication with
Amen.
God.
Amen.
So if we're constantly praying and asking God to show us a brighter day, then guess what? We will see a brighter day.
Amen.
Because the Bible already said he would do just what he said. My brothers and sisters, let us not become dry bones. As a result of not seeing what is right in front of us. Remember at the beginning, I said, in the introduction of Ezekiel, it says, people tend to do one or the other. They get in denial or despair. They refuse to accept what's in front of them, or they just give up altogether. And then they end up in a valley of dry bones. Sometimes people are in a valley of dry bones and don't even know it. When you're out of connection with God, you're possibly in a valley of dry bones. But here today, we're going to stay above the valley of dry bones. We're going to continue to stay in the Word of God. We're going to continue to share the good news of Jesus Christ with all of those we come in contact with.
Amen.
And most importantly, we're going to do what? We're going to pray.
Pray.
We must remain a hopeless people and always believe that the dead bones can be revived.
Amen.
Can we be revived today as a nation?
Every day.
Can we be a part of the revival?
Yes, yes, yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus,
Amen.
That we are not necessarily a church that has a field pew of dry bones.
Amen.
Because on this day, I believe that you are filled with the Holy Ghost. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Before we continue, Pastor Kim, and I'm sure everybody else feels the same way, I thank God that nobody got hurt when that bridge fell in town.
Amen.
I'm praying to God. I watched in anticipation, and I said, please don't let no bones up underneath all that fire
yes.
that occurred.
Yes.
And that we have a speedy recovery of our bridge situation.
Yes, Lord.
I didn't forget it's just sitting on my mind, but I'm sure y'all feel the same way.
Yes. Let us continue to pray for the situation. And we talked about that also in Sunday school this morning, just how blessed we were that there were no bodies found under the bridge. Because it could have gone another way.
Amen.
So we will pray for all the people who will be working on that project and continue to pray that things move swiftly so we can get back to the order of things.
Amen.
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 At this time, I will ask you to stand as we move into the invitation of discipleship. And at this time, if you feel like you are in the valley and you just want an extra word of prayer, it's all right. That's what we're here for, to pray for each other. Always make the assumption that people are all right. Things are not always what they seem. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Thanks be to God.
God is good. It's all good to be flexible. Amen.
Amen.
Our service of word is on of the Word of God and table is on page 12. If you are there, just say amen again.
Amen.
Christ our Lord invites to his table all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sins, and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sins before God and one another.
Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have failed to be an obedient church. We have not done your will. We have broken your law. We have rebelled against your love. We have not loved our neighbors. And we have not heard the cry of the need. Forgive us, we pray. Free us from your obedience. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Hear the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. That proves God's love toward us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven. Glory to God. Amen.
Great thanksgiving. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. And so, with your people on earth, and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed are blessed is, blessed are you. Blessed.
Holy.
Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. By the baptism of suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ, offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again.
Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here, and these gifts of bread and wine, make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ and one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ come in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with your Holy Spirit, in your holy church, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
Now we invite you to partake.
Thank you.
Christ's name, let us all together say,
Amen. Amen.